So bare total modulus is again something similar to the Lang factor, Lang equation, but it considers the effect of pressure and material of construction. So for bare modulus, this is the it tells us that the cost of the equipment, the total cost of the equipment, let's say the equipment itself, installation, I don't know, like labors altogether, the total cost of the equipment is the cost of equipment at ambient pressure and for carbon steel at 1 atmosphere and carbon steel times the bare factor. Bare module factor will consider the effect of pressure and material of construction. So let's say if I want to have a heat exchanger which is in stainless steel working at 100 bars, so I need to go find the price of that heat exchanger that is built, that is fabricated from carbon steel, CS is for carbon steel, and 1 atmosphere, and then I will use the bare modulus to correct for pressure and material of construction. FBM, which is the bare modulus factor that is used to correct for pressure and material of construction, has such an equation: is B1 plus B2 times FP times FM. B1 and B2 are two factors that we have tables, we go find them from the tables, and FP and FM, this is the factor that is correct the pressure, and this is the factor that will correct the material of construction. If my operating pressure is 1 bar, this factor will be 1. If my material of construction is carbon steel, this factor will be 1. Okay. And in that case, when both these factors are 1, it means for 1 atmosphere or 1 atmosphere and 1 bar, okay, 1 atmosphere and 1 bar, then the modulus factor, the bare module factor, the F, will be something like that. When FP and FM, both of them are 1, this is 1, this is 1, so this equation will be B1 plus B2, that we just put a 0 here to indicate that this is for the base condition. Okay, that's about this part. And also sometimes we use this equation that corrects the pressure of, I mean, the effect of pressure and material of construction in the total cost of the equipment. Okay, so like this is not very useful, but it's only, you know, like we can combine all this equation together, like all these four equation together, and reach to some other equation that you can see in the next slide. So I'm not gonna really, you know, make you confused and spend a lot of time on it, because the most important thing is that you have to be able to use this equation at the end. That's all. So considering that, consider this base equation, total cost of the equipment at certain pressure and certain material of construction is the cost of that equation at 1 bar and carbon steel times bare modulus. If your bare module is coming from this equation, if you put this equation here that you will see in the next slide, we will reach to this equation. What I have done, I just replaced FMB from this equation here. That's the only thing I do, and you can write it in this way as well. This is the equation that we will use mainly in all in the rest of this this unit. All right. So now, B1 and B2 are given in our tables. In table A4, one of them is table A4 that you can see in the next slide, and also B1 and BF, B1 and B2, they are given for different equipments in table A4 that you will see in the next exercise, as I said. And FM, okay, FP most of the time will be given to you, or if it's in one bar, you just put it one. FM, material of construction, we have also a figure and table all together. We use a figure and table all together to find FM. You will see all of them in the next slides. Okay, this is one example of how we find B1 and B2. We have such a table A4. Constant of bare modular factor used in equation A4. This is equation A4. So for heat exchanger, for process vessels, horizontal, vertical, for pumps, compressor, like for most of the equipments, we have this bare factors. Okay, so depending to the type of the heat exchanger, you will go choose the right B1 and B2. Let's say if I tell you we have a positive displacement pump. Positive displacement pump, what is B1 and B4 is here. If I have a floating head heat exchanger, this is something that you're supposed to have seen in your PO 1150 course, the course that I'm teaching. So we have this factor. So we talk about the different type of heat exchanger. So if I tell you I have a floating head heat exchanger, what will be the bare value? It will be B1 and B2. Alright, so this is something that we needed to know. Now what I'm going to do is, okay, so B1 and B2, we just go find it from this table. Then okay, for FM, material of construction, we have also FM is a factor. Depending to the type of the material that we will use to construct, to fabricate the equipment, we have different FM or material factor. So for material factor, we use this figure 8A8. Okay, in this figure, what we have x-axis, that is identification number from the table A3. So for each equipment, you have to go look at the table that you will see in the next slide, and from that table you will find the identification number of that equipment, and then you come back to this table, to this figure, and depending to the identification number, you go pick for each identification number, you go pick the corresponding FM. So what is table A3? Table A3 is such a table that you have from 1 to slide 32, from 1 to 24, and then from 25 to 40, slide 33. Okay, so how we use this? Let's say I have a air cooler. Again, don't forget if you have a carbon steel, your material of your construction material equipment is made of carbon steel, the factor will be 1. If not, you have to come to this table. So let me tell you I have a air, come on, what's wrong with this? Okay, so I have air cooler alright, that is made of aluminium tube. Air cooler made of aluminium tube. What is FM for this air cooler from aluminium tube? Air coolers are here. This is carbon steel, this is aluminium, this is stainless steel. Aluminium, then what's the identification number? Is 11. Alright, so Then I use this identification number 11. This is 10, this is 11. I go to this figure and find my FFM. So 11, you go all the way horizontally, you will have FM here. That is, this is from 1 to 2 is divided to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. Okay, so this will be 1.4. This is my FM. So for each identification number, let's say if you have if you have 28, okay, you go find this from here. If you have 28, it will be somewhere here. Okay, so for each identification number, you go and find it from this figure. Then, okay, those are the table that we already talked about. And okay, so for some so for some of the equipments, okay, some very specific equipments like fire heater and furnace, or for tower, packed tower or sieve tray, or power recovery equipments. For very specific equipments, we have like this table, actually like table A5, it lists those equation, okay, for very specific type of equipment. Okay, so in general, this is the general form of bare modulus equation. Okay, bare modulus equation that we will use, but for some specific equipment that is not listed either here or in this tables, okay, we will have some specific equation for those tables, okay, for those equipments like evaporators, like fan. So those are all the equations that we have for some equipments that we cannot find in the other figures, other tables. No need to go through the details because we are not going to use it, but it's just for your information that for any equipment, for almost all the equipments that we have in a plant, we have a corresponding equation or value to find the total cost of that equipment at operating at any pressure, with built and fabricated from any material. That's the total, the whole mass idea. That's the main message of this slide. Okay, how we can find CP0. Okay, CP0, as I said, is the total purchase cost of the equipment at 1 bar and carbon steel. So CP0 is the cost of the total purchase cost of the equipment. Okay, where we need CP0, we need it here. In bare modulus, we need CP0. How we can find it? It will be either given to you, in most of the cases it will be given to you, or you have to find it in any way. Okay, one of the way to find it is using this equation. Okay, it's a long equation that gives you CP0. As I said, CP0 is the cost of the purchase cost of the equipment at 1 bar and carbon steel. To either will be given to you, as I said, most of the time it will be given to you, or we will use this equation. In this equation, you need K1, K2, which is related to the capacity of that equipment. You remember that the first equation that we had in this unit, and K3. All these parameters are given in a certain table and center appendix that, as I said, I'm not gonna talk, and like we're not gonna use this equation for now, because it's out of the scope of this unit. Okay, but whenever if you, it's just, you know, like is why I'm introducing all this stuff to you, because in future you might need to, you know, like you are working as an engineer or you're for capstone project, you need to calculate some the price of some equipments. This is the way that you can do it. Okay, Appendix A is also is related to the textbook that we use for this course, and is also the textbook. The name of textbook is also available in your course outline. Okay, and okay, the cost. This is just one additional information that the cost for the equipments are mainly calculated based on September 2001. This is the latest update that we have, and you remember that we had the chemical engineering purchase cost in the index. Okay, that was chemical engineering process cost index was this for 2001. We already saw this in the first video. Okay, so if let's say when you get this purchase cost for a certain equipment is like from this equation, it gives you the purchase, the cost of that equipment in 2001, right? So if you want to, let's say if you are designing a plant now today, or let's say next year, so you need the price, you need to adjust the price based on the year that you are building or designing the plant that we use. If you remember, we use this equation to correct the price for time, for the year of construction or building. Then finding bare modules B0 F0 FBM0, if you remember, is this one, is this one, B1 plus B2. So B1 and B2, they have the inside B1 and B2, there are some, is a factor, is a value, is a number that they have all the costs inside. All the costs is already inside them. B1 and B2 are those factors that all the costs are already considered in them. What is the cost? Cost for the fabricating the equipment, material cost, labor cost, I don't know, like taxes, like all the costs that correspond to the equipment is already there. And by like how they calculate this is already by default. If you remember in part one, in first video, I had a table that I was telling you, typically, like let's say 10% is for material, I don't know, 15% is for instruments, 5% is tax, 11% is for labor, 20% is for the testing, things like that, right? So these two factors are calculated based on those kind of tables, or you know, like a general method that is used by many companies, many engineers. That I mean, is like something that is agreed between all the companies. Most of the company they agree that let's say the labor for building a heat exchanger, for fabricating a heat exchanger, the labor cost is about 20%. I don't know, the material cost is about 30%. All the companies they agree on that, and that's why, and that's how we calculate this modulus. So for some specific cases that is really different from the general thing that all the companies they agree. Let's say I'm building a new equipment that the material, or a new type of heat exchanger, that the material that I will use will be very specific. The method that I will build it will be very specific. I'm building that heat exchanger somewhere far from city, that labor is expensive. In those case, we can still find F0BM by some specific method or equation. What is that equation? Is this one. So for very specific case that we have a special material, a special labor, overhead expenses, so we will use this equation to find F0BM. So in F0BM we have different factors. We have material factor, we have labor factor, we have freight, insurance, and tax factor, again labor factor, overhead factor, And alpha E is the engineering work that we need to do. So what does this equation mean? This equation is again the mere module cost that consider all direct, indirect, contingency fees, and all the indirect costs, direct costs, contingency fees, and taxes, fees that we have actually. So okay, no need to really go through these tables. Okay, so what we need to do is only we have one example that we will find all these alphas, and then we will calculate the bare module cost. Just before we start, alpha for equipment is 1. Okay, this is just keep it in your mind. For material is A.AM. For labor is the factor that we have to use is this one. For again for the overhead we will use this equation. So those are the equations that we will use in the next slide, and you will see how we will calculate that bare module cost.